Mehmet, you and I have worked together for a long time, and you're definitely one of the best surgeons I've ever worked with. But you know, cardiac surgery isn't getting any easier, and I do have an obligation to make sure my surgeons can still keep up.
Keep up? Are you kidding me? I did 11 network interviews today alone. Listen, you may have operated on President Clinton, but I did the exclusive on him.
Well, that's not exactly what I mean. You see, there's a brilliant young guy in L.A. who's just dying to join our department. I'd rather keep you. You're a brilliant surgeon, sort of the known quantity, bird in the hand. But you really need to show us you can still do what it takes.
Well, you know, I'm never afraid of a challenge. What do you have in mind?
Well, you remember the movie Billy Madison?
The one with that dancing British kid?
I didn't know you were a leotard guy. No, that's Billy. That's Billy Elliot. Billy Madison was a 1995 Adam Sandler movie where the premise is that Sandler has to prove he can run the family business by going back through school 1 through 12, one grade every 2 weeks.
I'm sorry, so you want me to repeat first grade?
No, that would be a lot to ask, although actually I'd pay tuition to see that. But all I need you to do is repeat residency all 5 years, one day for each year.
That's it? Just be a resident for 5 days? I mean, that seems easy. I can do that in my sleep.
Well, then we'll set it up.
Who's going to take my place when I'm here doing residency again?
Well, that's not a problem. You know how good the Columbia residents are. So we'll just pull one of them and have them cover you every day.
So don't forget, you got a 2 o'clock important meeting with Jeff Zucker. That's to plan the upcoming special. You're meeting with Nancy Gibbs. Critical. It's going to review my recent Time column in the next upcoming issue. I've got to be able to follow through with. I also got this photo shoot for the new magazine, which is big ass. Staff meeting with the entire crew. It's about 200 people. I want you there. I want you psyched and prepped. And make sure you get your slides ordered in the right order. These guys are very, very critical. Finally, my wife, she's expecting a lot from you. She wants me to take her out on Friday night for a 10-mile run before we take all the kids to dinner. Then we'll drive up to Boston afterwards. And don't forget, 2 pints of allergy juice for the road trip. Nothing else. You gotta juice it yourself. Finally, we've got today's show coming up. We're going to do it on Monday and Tuesday and Wednesday. So you got 3 different segment producers going to call you. Make sure you're on board with it. And finally, we've got coffee beans, green coffee beans. Everyone wants them. We're going to talk about them quite honestly. We're going to film that on my show. Any questions?
Dr. Oz, I'm a fourth-year surgery resident. I haven't done this. I'm not TV. How do I do this?
It's actually very, very simple. Always keep the humanity in all you do. Be compassionate. Remember, your most powerful tool is the hug. Good luck, my friend. There's your calendar.
Mehmet, I want you to know you're still 2 weeks behind the logging your work hours. You're totally non-compliant.
So what do I got to do to pre-op this liver patient?
Find out where the patient is. Make sure that you put in all the orders, including all the pre-op orders. You want to afterwards get all the labels. Go see the patient. Do a full H&P. Do a physical exam. Draw the labs. Do wait. Hold. There's more.
When your day is long and the night is yours alone, when you're sure you've had enough of this life, hang on.
Don't let you. I wonder how that resident is doing in my place.
Sorry, Mr. President. Somebody was trying to get a hold of me. Anyways, like I said, I cannot be part of this. I cannot be part of this task force. I'm just too important. I don't have the time. I'm just too important.
Mike.
Dr. Josh.
I'm gonna need you on Thursday.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm gonna need you on Thursday.
For what?
I need some help in the OR Thursday. You free?
Absolutely. For you, I'm always available.
All right.
No problem.
Thursday. Thanks, Mike.
You got it.
Thanks.
My pleasure.
Thanks.
Nice to see you, Dr. Josh. Nice to see you.
Come on in.
Martha?
Oh, hi. Who are you?
Dr. Josh.
Oh, I'm, Dr. Josh.
I'm taking Dr. Oz's place for the day. He's busy. So, do you come here often?
I try. I come here once every 2 weeks.
Oh. How's everything?
Everything's just fine, except that I have some turkeys who have head colds.
Oh.
And I don't want them to be sick for Thanksgiving.
Well, recommend zinc. I recommend zinc.
Zinc for my turkeys?
Zinc for the turkeys.
Oh, somebody told me to just use Vicks VapoRub all over their throats and their wattles.
It may have zinc in it.
Okay.
It may.
Thanks for your advice.
Thank you. Hey, good luck on the show today.
Thank you.
Go, Josh.
I'm finally going to be chief. It's going to be fabulous. I get to operate with Chabot, get to do the big cases. I get to own the place. And you know what? The fourth year, they get to do all the consults for me up at the Allen. Oh, this is so good.
Excuse me, Doc. I'm sorry, honey.
Can't
have this coffee here.
No coffee at the station. Okay. Mm. You're going to have to.
Well, that's so nice.
Dr. Smith needs to see you in his office right now.
Congratulations on getting through 5 years of residency. Didn't think you could do it.
There's nothing.
Just got a phone call from the guy in L.A. He reminded me of one little wrinkle.
What's that?
You still have to pass a fellowship.
Oh, how are we going to do that?
Well, I think we got a good way worked out. There will be a trivia contest. Mano a mano, you against him. So start studying.
Trivia contest? Oh.
Welcome to the Daniels Auditorium and the showdown between Dr. Mehmet Oz and his challenger. But first, let's meet our contestants. Dr. Oz is a world-renowned cardiac surgeon, television host, and a medical expert. He's widely known as America's doctor. Oh, and he's just completed his fifth year of surgical residency. Now let's meet his challenger, who's joining us by video conference.
Dr. Billy Madison completed high school at the age of 27 and went on to have an illustrious college and medical school career in Los Angeles. He recently completed cardiac surgery fellowship, where he was very highly regarded. Welcome, Dr. Madison.
Thank you, Dr. Amory. It's really cool, man. I can't wait to come to Columbia. I used to be a part of your record deal with the 10 albums for a penny, and it's just good that you're bringing that back. Way to go, man.
Well, okay then, Dr. Oz. Here's your first question. What is the treatment of an aortic dissection?
Well, I guess you do have to go to the operating room, but there's much more to it than that. It's the hand-holding that makes you very special. You need to be able to connect with people, you know, be next to them, look them in the eyes, make sure that they identify with you. I mean, we're defined by the people in our lives. I'll have more on that after a word from our sponsors.
I guess we'll award you half credit.
Better than nothing.
Now it's your turn, Dr. Madison. What is the cardiac physiology in which outflow obstruction from hypertrophy can lead to sudden death?
You'll never get that.
Physiology, schmiziology. This is all hokum.
Yes, that is correct. Hypertrophic obstructive cardiomyopathy, otherwise known as hokum physiology, is the right answer. All right, Dr. Oz, here is your final question. What is the origin of the name of the mitral valve?
Oh, I know this one. It comes from the Pope's hat. It's named the mitre, and the valve is shaped just that way.
Correct. Oof.
Dr. Madison, the score is 1.5-1. You have the final question. If you get this correct, you win. This is not so much a question about your medical knowledge as it is about your decision-making and judgment. So the question is, which is better, shampoo or conditioner?
Shampoo is better. I go on first and clean the hair. Conditioner is better. I leave the hair silky and smooth. Oh, really, fool, really. Stop looking at me, Swan.
Well, you know, the truth is, shampoo is better because it does clean the hair. You all realize that. But on the other hand, conditioner really does leave the hair feeling silky smooth. So you got to put that into consideration. Conditioner possibly is winning on that end. Shampoo and conditioner, you know, it's a tight race. I'm not sure. I can't really decide. Let's pretend this never happened.
I'm sorry, Dr. Madison. That is the wrong answer. I'm afraid you lose. Dr. Oz has proven that he still has what it takes to be a top-notch cardiac surgeon. I present to you the winner, Dr. Oz.
First of all, they're different sizes because in most human males who have testicles, the testicles are different sizes. They're also different sizes because I think our props department may have just killed one more than the other. They're also great for dancing.
Doc, thank you for these. We'll be right back after. Smartest man alive, and here's the smartest woman. Say hello. Say hello. Yes.